Have you ever tried to create dynamic invoices directly within Make and you failed? Well, today I'm going to show you two different solutions how you can avoid this pitfall and create dynamic PDFs, dynamic invoices with dynamic elements on it at ease. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of Techflow.ai and we love automation. So today we are going to look into how to auto create and send invoices with make.com. And if you want more tutorials like this, make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Turn on the notifications so you're not missing out on any future tutorials. We are using Shopify test orders to demonstrate this use case. And we have multiple line items in that order, and that is usually the issue that we are facing. There are modules for Google Docs, for example, where you can create a document from a template, but that is not really dynamic because you have to pre-fill a fixed amount of values or rows in there in this template. And I mean, someone could order one item or they could order 10 or 20 items, but that one won't break. So our workaround here is using HTML, and I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. So first, let's look at the order, how it looks like. It's coming in with multiple line items down here, the Shopify. We have three line items, like different ones. This is an example t-shirt for $19.99. And then there's example jacket for $99 and example pants. And we want to create an invoice for that with dynamic values. How do we do this? Well, in the end, we use the Google Docs create a document module, and that allows to input HTML. And with this HTML, we are able to create dynamic elements like a table element, for example, which has dynamic amount of line or rows in that table, and create it dynamically with this combination of the iterator and text aggregator. If you're not familiar with iterator, we'll link a video here how to use the rate aggregator and iterator on make.com, which will finally solve this problem for you, understanding the concept of iterating and aggregating. And this will also help you understanding this concept unless you're already familiar with it. So we are iterating the line items here. So we split them apart no matter how many there are. And then we are generating the table part with dynamic rows dynamically with text aggregator. So this one even got a little bit more advanced version in it because it's using classes to use certain CSS. So the rows are alternating between gray background and white background. So it's even visually nice appearing, but you don't necessarily need that. You can also simplify this by just having one of these parts here and not having this if function. And then you can set the quantity, the price, and whatever else you need in your lines of for your invoice, and the title is over here. And then it will be inserted in your main HTML. Whoops, let me get here. So in the main HTML, we have it somewhere down here. So here we have the table rows. This one is the header. So we have the total and the quantity and the unit price and so on. And then for the next table row, we insert the dynamic ones we generate over here with the text aggregator. And ultimately we have the subtotal one and the discount and the subtotal less discount, and also the shipping fee, as well as the grand total values as separate rows, which are just formatted differently, so they're not like looking like a table. So then we download this as a document, as a PDF, because we want to attach it to an email and send it to a customer. So here we're just sending it to myself, and then a simple email, and we attach the Google Docs download document file because we want to have it the PDF attached, and then we have it as a nicely formatted dynamic invoice. By the way, we're using the set multiple variables here to format different parts of the invoice dynamically, because making edits in this HTML makes it super complex, and it's far easier if we modify certain elements like company name and so company address location in these variables. So sometimes it's worth it to simply use a set multiple variables module, even if it costs one operation extra. And you can create this main structure first in an online HTML editor, like htmlonline.com, for example. And here you basically design your invoice design, and then you copy and paste it over to your make module. Or you can also create a Google Doc, and then you can download it as HTML to get the raw HTML structure of that nicely formatted Google Doc, and then start replacing certain elements with your dynamic elements. Now let's run this to see how it actually looks like. I will start with the order number 15. So it iterates the three line items that we already saw before. It creates this HTML over here, which is basically the three rows separated. And then it inserts it in the main document as HTML. It downloads the document as PDF and then sends it as an email attachment. So let's see how that looks like. Okay, here we go. We have the PDF attachment and it looks like this. We have the three items here. And it is super dynamic. Now, this is all great and is already enough for the majority of the users. But there's one thing that these invoices can't do, and that is pagination. So if you have too many rows here, it will not break it down into proper pages. And therefore, there's also another way, which is a little bit easier to use. It's a little bit different to use. And it keeps footers and headers that you pretty fine. And the way that it works is actually using Vert. So how does it work with Vert? Well, we have a Vert template in docx format, this one over here. And basically you just put in variables with the curly braces wherever you want to put in some dynamic values like company name, company location, website, customer details, invoice number, and so on. So you make everything dynamic with the curly braces. Then I just added a bunch of lines down here just to showcase the pagination. So whenever this one breaks, we have added the page number on the footer, then it should sum up the page number and put page number two on the second page of the invoice. And the magic here is using, let me zoom in a little bit, is using the hashtag items and then item description, item quantity, item price, item total, and then /items. So this part here makes it dynamic, and that allows you to insert dynamic amount of items with this Word format template. By the way, you don't need Word for this. You can simply create it in Google Docs, and you also don't need any Word connection in or Microsoft connection in Make. There is a module for this, which is called fill the document with a batch of data. So it's in the Microsoft Word templates, and then fill the document with a batch of data. And this is really powerful. It doesn't require anything, any connection. You simply can work with the file that I just showed you. Now, we download the docx template that we created, then we iterate the line items from our Shopify again, like we did previously. And then the fill a document with a batch of data is basically acting as an aggregator. So we use this and fill it out with all the values. So value, key, company name, that is our template for company name over here. So it needs to match the exact name here. And then you can put in whatever value you want. So the next type is value type again, key, value type again, value, and then company location and whatever address that is, and so on. So you continue doing that for all variables that you have in your Word template. And then we are getting to the magic, which is the loop or section value type. Here, our key is items, and then we put item description, item quantity, item price, item total. And that's basically it. So we map this from our iterator, and it will repeat that process for every single item in that iteration. So it will work for one, it will work for three, it will work for 20 line items nicely. And here are some other values like the subtotal, the discount, the subtotal discount, the shipping, and the grand total price. And then we just upload the Word file to our Google Drive that we just generated over here. We download it again as a PDF, just like we did before, and then we send the PDF to the customer. So let's run this one now and see how it looks like. All right, so here's our root version now, and it looks like this. So here we have the first page of the invoice. We have it all dynamic. This time it's not white and gray alternated, and it's slightly different font, but you can modify anything on the Word document that you want, of course. And now here's the magic. You have two pages because I added these extra lines in template, which are not making any sense, but I wanted to demonstrate the page break, and it breaks the page here. And then we have our page number two down here, and that is oftentimes a requirement. So make sure that you are using Word format if that's a requirement for you, if you want to keep it simpler, or if you prefer the HTML version or want to have other values in it, then use the Google Doc version of this solution. All right, I hope this helped. You like this and got a lot of value from this. So leave us a comment below and tell us where you want to use these dynamic invoices or dynamic documents, and what possibilities this opens up for you now that you have this knowledge and can create these scenarios. Like this video, subscribe to our channel, and turn on the notifications so you're not missing out on any of these tutorials. Thank you for watching.